It is a highly contentious subject. What does the data tell us? What does the science tell us? We should know the answers.
Cannabis for a long time has been considered a fringe issue, and it deserved to have a conversation about the science and the public health impacts and the criminalization altogether.
The history of cannabis is intertwined in large part with demonizing the drug rather than trying to understand not just, you know, the biology and also the education.
We need to really understand what these drugs do to the brain.
I felt like it was really important to try to report on the latest science, how it impacts our body and brain, its potential medicinal benefits, its risk. At the same time, I don't think you can talk about cannabis and not talk about racism. So I tried to straddle both.
We should have cannabis medicine being taught in every single medical school across the United States, and that's not happening now because of federal law.
There has been a lot of barriers to cannabis research because cannabis is considered a very addictive drug and not to have any medicinal value. So therefore, it's labeled as a Schedule I drug.
That inhibits our ability for funding and also research.
For the first time, you've got a drug derived from cannabis for mainstream medicine to study.
We've known for years it's been an effective treatment for patients with HIV. It's been used for years by chemotherapy patients. Their trials now looking at cannabis in terms of migraines, multiple sclerosis, PTSD.
Individuals that newly initiate cannabis use report it being life-changing.
The public has been lied to for a very long time around drugs and especially around cannabis.
There are multiple sides to understanding this complex question, but we should understand that it also comes with responsibility, like with any other drug.